Sports. It's in the game.
Shotgun come with the options and big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot, trying to bend the corner of your limbs, getting that's your partner, then your twin.
Don't want your bro, it was for show, just so you know.
We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give him a show, killing you knows and taking your bro.
And spinning his bands, oh yeah, did it again, oh yeah, out with his friend, oh yeah, Chanel is the lens,
okay.
With his friend finna get lit, I'm everything on they wish list, which bag should I get, which color should I pick, any, mini, money, mo, all his money, I need mo, you big bro, gotta go, big bird giving crow,
a group of baddies coming foe,
give me money, kiss my toes, don't with your bro, it was for show, just so you know, we just wanna get lit, we just wanna get lit, wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro. It was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the great state of Tennessee at Nissan Stadium here in Nashville. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the Cleveland Browns. Ready to get it started, Sam Ficken has it teed up, and off we go from Nashville. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone, and only able to get this to the 19. So probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now Mayfield. And his first look is incomplete.
I'd give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing, Mayfield. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Just what the Browns needed there. Good for a gain of 17. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Mayfield down. Going out wide, finds Chubb. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. It really gets them amped up as they go forward. Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook. Go play action. Toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Chubb on first down. No room to roam as he struggles just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards. Back to the 33. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you...
Now Mayfield lost the football.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
So they recover their own fumble. Now they face third and short. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb, and he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. 4 yards on the pickup, good enough to extend the drive. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. A run for Nick Chubb, and he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of 3. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. They'll try to throw here. Mayfield, and he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Jayon Brown. Able to take him down. It's a loss of 3.
Well, they sent him on the blitz from that linebacker spot, and boy, he got there quickly.
He certainly did, and obviously he could have used a block from his running back, but I think you nailed it right there. The defender got to the backfield so fast, it's hard for anyone to react.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Elijah Molden.
And the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line. But no doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
They'll rumble for about 6 up across the 20 to the 22.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. Tannehill with a play fake to Henry. He'll throw instead. He'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. Tannehill to his top target, Brown, for a Tennessee first.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. And this is going to be a Titans first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line. No score after 1 on EA Sports. play fake, and it's Tannehill. Eluding the pressure right. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
That one brought back a few nightmares, because when a quarterback gets outside of the pocket, your job as a defensive back, make sure you stay as deep as the deepest receiver and not let anyone leak behind you for a big play. A nice job there, having discipline and not letting them connect on that pass.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Play action, it's Tannehill. He's got his tight end, Anthony Firkser. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. First target, first catch, and a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
A gain of 3, second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Second and 6. No, scratch that. Second and 7. They'll fake the handoff. Now Tannehill. He's going deep for Brown. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And he will bring it out past the 20-yard line.
You've seen me out here.
Well, a shaky start for both quarterbacks now. We had the interception on the opening drive, and now they throw it right back to him.
So does that mean we're really kind of starting from the beginning, Brandon, right? Both of them have done it, so we kind of start from scratch. Looks to me like both of these defenses have done their homework, and they're executing quite well.
And he still has yet to get on track in this first half, as they're going to stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. And finding the tight end, Hooper. So a PI call going to cost him there defensively. What did you see?
Well, I think it's the right call, partner, because sometimes we'll see officials kind of let him play. But by the letter of the law, that's definitely a penalty.
Trying to get it to Beckham, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Amani Hooker. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available, and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Trying to run inside, but nothing there.
Well, sometimes it's hard to take your eyes off this guy at the linebacker position. He can really cover some ground, and he did there to make that play.
And I have to think that when this play began, the running back thought to himself that this looks promising, but that feeling certainly didn't last very long. Super play defensively to lock in on the best route to his target, and he stopped him for no gain.
And the final number here in terms of top speed, I mean, that almost looks like a misprint. He was just absolutely flying. Unbelievable.
Off play action, Tannehill. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete.
And that's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
From the 21, it's second and 10. They'll fake it. Now Tannehill. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
And Mayfield again with the interception, his third.
Picked by Kevin Byard. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Boy, Charles, that is now three interceptions in three consecutive drives, and you can see he's just got a look of disgust and bad body language, understandably, as he walks off the field.
And I think it comes from the fact that he's not sure what he sees down the field, Brandon. I don't know if he's seeing ghosts. I don't know if he just can't read defenses. I'm not sure what it is, but that's why he's frustrated. Think about the defense right now. Every time they run on the field, they've gone from hoping to intercept a pass to expecting to intercept passes. They're confident and at an all-time high right now.
2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. The first red zone opportunity for the Titans. First and 10 right at the 20. Now it's Tannehill. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he'll be out of bounds. That puts him in excellent position, first and goal after a gain of 19.
That's a nice job of working his way open down in the red zone. Looked that one in, and then made a beeline for the pylon. He didn't quite get there, and you want to give him a little extra for the effort, but instead he sets his guys up in excellent shape with a first and goal.
Into a mass of bodies, and I think they held him out. They did. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Derrick Henry from a yard away bowling his way in as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. They were able to stop him at the line on first down, but this time he punches his way through.
And sometimes just because you're stopped on the first run, it doesn't mean the play call was bad or incorrect. You might just need better execution and just a tad more determination. And they got it done on the second try.
This is JoJo Natson. And he returns this to the 22. Drive about to get started. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play call.
He's got a man complete. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25.
But Baker Mayfield, only 6'1", but he can certainly sling it. And we saw evidence of that right there.
So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10 to throw Mayfield. And this one is incomplete.
Well, I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
Throwing again, Mayfield on second and 10. Touchdown, Browns! Anthony Schwartz, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Browns are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go.
And they've got just under 50 seconds, so time enough to try to work their way downfield if they so choose.
Looking deep for Julio. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. John Johnson with the INT. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line.
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Now, easy to second-guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break. Now, Mayfield lost the football. Second time in this game, Charles, the ball has squirted out from his hands. Luckily, his teammate was there to pounce on it.
You're right. Got the lucky bounce, able to retain possession. You know, we often talk about the combine, and why do we measure quarterbacks' hands? Is that really a big deal? It's for situations like this. Do you have the hands big enough and strong enough to hold on to the football while being jostled?
And now this throw incomplete, and that is how this first half will come to an end. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Final adjustments being made in both locker rooms. We're just about ready for the second half. And for the call, let's get you back up to Nashville, Music City, and Brandon Gott.
And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gott, getting set for quarter number three here. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Here's Tannehill. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah on the tackle.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
From just shy of midfield, Tannehill. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Troy Hill picks it. There he goes, left side. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown.
Well, it certainly looked to me like he tapped into the quarterback's thought process there. And what I'm hearing more and more when I go around the league, defenders sitting in on quarterback meetings trying to learn more about how they think so they can be in the right position to be in the right spot, as he was there to pick that one off and take it all the way back for a touchdown.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
From the 22, Tannehill. Man open, here is Jones. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Here's Tannehill. Got a man. It's Brown. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and you can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Throwing again on second down, Tannehill. He's got it complete, Derrick Henry. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Good work after the catch, going to net him 23 and a first.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
On first and 10, Tannehill. Complete to Jones. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of six. A gain of six there on first.
That's now four completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Trying to punch it in with Henry. And he's going to get this back to the three-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, but it sets up second and goal.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Josh Reynolds there to make the grab. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point by Fickett, up and good. And that will tie our game here in the third. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Browns drive about to get started, and their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline, and he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Anthony Schwartz, the intended target,
but it's going to be second down. Mayfield on play action. He's going to go up top again. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
Picked off by Christian Fulton.
You can try and underthrow it and go back shoulder, but your timing has to be impeccable. And here, I think it's much more of a duck than a designed back shoulder throw.
Henry on first down, not finding much running room as he pushes forward for a yard or two at most.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
Flush to his right. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Throwing on third down, Tannehill. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by MJ Stewart, and he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line.
Well, they were in a great position to take the lead, Charles. Obviously, all they needed was a field goal to do that. They wanted the touchdown. Unfortunately, they're going to get neither.
And you know every offense talks about the same thing each week, don't they, Brandon? They want to end every drive with a kick, whether it's a field goal attempt, a point after the touchdown, or at worst, a punt. This time, they had that opportunity but didn't get it because you know the field shrinks that close to the end zone, and that allows a defense to tighten up their coverage, and they pick that one off.
Play fake. Mayfield. Pressure comes and down goes Baker Mayfield. Bud Dupree, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. Mayfield in this Browns offense staring at a 3rd and long now after the sack. Mayfield looks to throw. Under pressure, and they got to him again. That sack by the DN, Danico Autry.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. 5 defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the proper price.
Okay, how much were they, a dime? What were they?
15 cents.
A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line. A few things better than a big man interception. You can always tell right when they get the football, there's that level of excitement and nervousness and also like, what the heck do I do with this thing?
And you say, no better sight? Well, not for the quarterback who just threw it. It's bad enough to throw a pick, but throw one to the big guy? But you're right about that. Now what do I do with it? But what's fun about it is, you know they're going to be in the film room after this ball game, tell all their teammates, maybe I should shift over to offense. I've got skills. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. I always find myself cheering for them after they intercept it. Unfortunately here, he couldn't make it into the end zone. 23 yards the pickup there. So not quite a 1st and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. Here's Mayfield. Drops it off for Chubb. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down. Now Mayfield. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up 3rd down. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big 3rd down. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. Escaping the pressure right. Yeah, he's got it. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Just a 5-yard pickup, but it leads to 4th down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
So he waited on the sideline for his 1st chance in the ball game, and it didn't come until the 4th quarter, but he connects there, a big one to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net.
you're not really ready when you go out there and all that beef is coming at you trying to block the kick. Big spot, and he delivers.
Oh, good return up past the 30. Past midfield. Still going. And he will score. They had just relinquished the lead on the field goal. Ensuing kickoff, they get that lead right back.
So does this come under the heading of you can't keep a good team down?
There you go. That works. Eye for an eye.
I'm with you on that one. Juice would be able to break back immediately. Not down at all. No heads down after giving up the lead and coming right back at them. And a special team score, that's like gold in a coach's manual.
JoJo Natson now on the return. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. The Browns drive about to get started. Now Mayfield. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Monty Rice in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. Here's Baker. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds.
Good, sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he was able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
Mayfield. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
Desperation time. Mayfield on fourth down. He's going to let it fly. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Titans, they've got the football back, and they've got it in great field position. A first down carry for Henry. Open space inside the 10. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it. Well, this, of course, set up by the stop a moment ago on fourth down. And now that might be the score that puts this one officially out of reach.
And it's a tough one because your hands are tied when you're losing in the fourth quarter because you know you've got to make something happen. They couldn't pick up the first down. And after that, the air just went right out of the balloon. And you knew you were looking at a defeated team.
Returning it, here's Natson. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver. But now it's third down. Mayfield. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
Fourth down, Mayfield. He's going to let it fly. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Tannehill going to throw it. That's caught by McMahon. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Tannehill. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Anthony Frisker, the intended target, but it'll be second down.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. One receiver right, that's Brown. Tannehill on third down. Open man, Julio. Touchdown, Tennessee. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Titans have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Extra point by Ficken, up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. Now Ficken to kick off following the touchdown. To return it, it's Nansen. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Drive about to get started. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. One last shot for Mayfield here. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
We'll be right back.